Hello, I'm Sharon Martin. I'm a psychotherapist in San Jose, California. In this video, I'm going to talk about enmeshment. So let's start with trying to understand what that means. I would describe enmeshment as relationships that are overly close. And that can be a bit confusing because generally we want our relationships to be close. So it seems odd that they could be too close. So I would describe enmeshment as really sort of relationships that are intertwined. Maybe people are kind of sewn together in enmeshed relationships, so much so that they can't be separated. They can't be separate individuals with their own ideas, values, beliefs, goals, desires. So for simplicity, we can think about an enmeshed relationship between a parent and a child. Enmeshed relationships can happen in other types of relationships as well, but the parent-child one is very common. And we also see enmeshment happening across generations. So there might be multiple generations, grandparents, parents, children, all enmeshed. But like I said, for simplicity's sake, we'll use this example of what it's like for a child to grow up in an enmeshed family. So usually in Western culture, our expectation is that as a child gets to adolescence and then into early adulthood, there's a process of individuation of the child separating from the parents, both physically and emotionally. And part of this process is the development of the self, of the child becoming that separate person with their own identity, so that they're no longer just sort of an offshoot of their parents, but they're truly a separate person who can make their own choices and do whatever fulfills them in life. But in an enmeshed family, that process is stunted. It's shut down by the parents. They don't want the child to individuate and become a fully separate individual. They have rigid expectations for the child about what they're going to do, who they can spend time with, what they're going to believe in, where they're going to live, what kind of work they're going to do, all of those types of things. So generally, it's the parent has a specific idea about who the child is going to be. And often it also entails that the child should believe the same things that the parent believes. They want their child to have the same political views and the same religious beliefs that they do. And often there's a sense that if they don't, the child is doing something wrong. If they are doing something that's contrary to what the parent wants or what the parent believes. So if you grow up in an enmeshed family and you know that you're not who your parents want you to be, or you want to do something different in your life, you want to be a different person, make different choices in what they're expecting you to do, you will very quickly find that the enmeshment is a problem, right? There will be a conflict between you and your parents as you exert your individuality. So that's what happens for some people, is that they grow up and they know that this enmeshment is a problem. But there are actually a lot of people who grow up all the way into adulthood without realizing that they are in an enmeshed relationship or that the enmeshment is a problem. Because as I said, oftentimes the idea of being close to your family or spending a lot of time with your family, being loyal to your family, having these family connections is seen as a good thing. And not everybody in an enmeshed relationship feels overly controlled or restricted. Sometimes they do, as I said, but not always. And part of this is because it's a slow process that happens as a child grows up, so that if they're constantly getting the message that this is who you're supposed to be, this is what's going to make your parents happy, there aren't any other options that are acceptable, that's what they come to believe. And also, as I said, the idea of loyalty tends to be a big theme in enmeshed families, as are guilt and shame. And often in enmeshed families, you'll hear messages like, family's the most important thing. Only your family will be there for you. Family stick together. Or that this is what a good daughter would do or a good son would do. And so there's sort of these messages happening all the time that are, you know, maybe subtle or sometimes not so subtle ways of controlling or manipulating somebody into being the person that their parents want them to be. So often for people who have grown up, as I said, into adulthood without really seeing the enmeshment so much as a problem, they often then get to a point in life, and it's often when they get married or into a serious relationship, or maybe they go off to college. But essentially, once you start getting more messages from outside of your circle, often those messages include something negative about how involved your parents are, how controlling your parents are, or that it's unusual the amount of time that you spend with them, or it's unusual how emotionally dependent they are, the amount of very personal information that they share with you. It's another common theme in enmeshed relationships. Is this emotional dependency that happens often with the parent leaning on the child for emotional support, or they will share excessively personal information with the child, or information that is really sort of not appropriate. Even if you're an adult at this point, like it might be that, you know, if your mother is telling you about her marital problems with your father, I mean, you can handle that as an adult, certainly, but it's still, you should not be your mother's confidant with regards to issues between her and your father, perhaps. But anyway, as I was saying, issues of enmeshment often sort of come to a head when somebody is in a serious relationship, because it tends to cause problems between the person and their partner. As I was noting, often the partner will complain that, you know, your parents are too involved, you spend too much time with them, they take priority, you're always doing things for them, or you can't say no to them. And the partner feels like they are, you know, taking the back seat to the parents, and the parents are more important than he or she is, which of course causes problems in a significant relationship. So once you have gotten to the point of understanding what enmeshment is, you see the dynamics and you recognize that they're causing some issues for you, then you're at the point where you are ready to make some changes. And of course, this is the real hard part, because again, these are dynamics that have been going on for many, many years at this point. And we're not going to be able to change all of them, most likely. Especially if we want to maintain a relationship with our parents. It's normal to feel anxious and afraid of doing something that is going to anger them or cause them to be critical or rejecting. That is part of the dynamic that's dysfunctional in all of this. But we can start to set some small boundaries. And I would think of this all on a continuum of baby steps. Of making some small changes, seeing how they go, making adjustments, and at that same time, realizing that it is going to cause some ripples. There are going to be some people who are upset if you start making some changes. That piece is going to be unavoidable. You can't make changes and have everybody continue to be happy with you. Because again, that's part of the dynamic here that's not working for you. I think another important piece is getting some support from a therapist or from a support group. There are many 12-step groups, for example. There's Al-Anon, there's Codependence Anonymous, or Adult Children of Alcoholics and Dysfunctional Families, and there are others as well. The benefit of using a support group of some type is that you're getting some outside perspectives, which can be really helpful just as some reality testing, helps break through some of the denial and really helps us figure out, you know, is this healthy? Is this dysfunctional? Is this working for me? As I said, it can be helpful to get another perspective on what's going on that's from outside of your family. And then I think that the other piece that can be helpful is to do some self-discovery work, because this is the piece that tends to not happen for people who grew up in enmeshed families, is they didn't get the opportunity to figure out who they are, to explore different parts of themselves. And I don't think it's ever too late for that. And it can be very fulfilling and satisfying to learn about different things that are out in the world, learn about yourself, see what you're interested in, try out new things, meet new people, rethink what your goals and values are. Again, it can be tough work, but I think there's a lot to be gained by figuring out more of who you are. Okay, well, that's going to do it for this video. I hope that it was helpful and you have learned a bit more about enmeshment.